Hello and welcome back to the channel, where I just needed to take a break from all the editing that I've been doing. I'm on the final of the Halloween videos, and I just needed to step away for a minute. But I won't get into the specifics of it, but this morning I needed to go and get a good deal on a Echo Timberwolf. And so this is not for me, this is for somebody else, this is for a customer. But I needed to get this good deal on a Timberwolf, and I found it. And so this right here is pretty par for the course here in Atlanta. There's a lot of individuals that find themselves somehow getting a crate of stuff from Home Depot that was takebacks. And that's what these are, I believe. One of them has a very different story than the other one, though. So this one right here has definitely been ran. It hasn't been ran much, but it has definitely been ran. You can tell it because there's sawdust buildup on the inside of this clutch cover. But as you can see, I mean, this is a brand spanking new saw. You know, it is freaking glorious new. This one right here, however, I think was, I don't know what's going on with this, because this seems like it has not been fired up at all. It seems that way. No smell of gasoline in the tank, anything like that. So, but it's missing a couple things. It's missing two screws right here that hold the cases together in that spot. And it's missing the gas cap. Very common type of stuff, you know, the gas cap at least, very common stuff for a display unit. The display units a lot of times get little parts like that robbed off of them. But yeah, so these two saws, I want to tell you the deal, what I got. So I decided I was going to get this one. This is the one that I was going to go for. So we talked about it, and I got it to $260. And he was happy for $260. I was happy for $260. I was like, why don't we do both of them for $400? It's like, nah, I can't do that. Can't do that. So, okay, well, I'm out. And so I leave, and I go get in the truck, and I'm punching in my numbers and stuff on maps. Gonna go someplace else. And I catch him out of the corner of my eye. And I roll down the window, and he's like, yeah, we'll do two for $400. So I had already made this deal of $260, and I was happy with that deal. I was very happy with that deal, you know? But then he offers me another, you know, two for $400. And so the way I see it is this one right here, I've only got $140 in it. You know, and it's straight up, it's a brand new saw. All I gotta do is replace those two bolts and a gas cap. So all total, I'm gonna have maybe $150 in this. It's a brand new saw. So this right here, guys, is gonna be the Christmas giveaway. This is gonna be the Christmas giveaway. I don't know exactly what I'm gonna do with it yet, but I will modify it. I'll probably keep it simple. I know the first thing is out of everybody's mouth and or fingers is port it, you know. But the thing is with these, you gain so little from porting, from my experience. And I mean, I've only done it once, and whenever I port another one, I don't know, maybe I'll do it, but the thing is there's only so much time I have. I'm not made out of time. And I've got to modify both of these saws because they both got to go out before Christmas. This one right here is going to go to one of you guys. So hang in there and look out for the Christmas giveaway videos. I will document every step of the way, whatever I do with this, and I'll come up with some way to give it away. Don't know what that way is going to be just yet. But it's probably going to be very subjective. So leave comments, okay? Leave comments. It's definitely going to a viewer of this channel. You know I like jokes. But I don't know, maybe I'll do, you know, pull a name out of the hat. That'd probably be the easiest. So don't worry about it on this video. There will be another specific Christmas giveaway video and where you can put your name at the bottom if you want it, kind of thing. And yeah, we'll do a random draw. Because last time I got subjective, it didn't work out so well. So we'll do a random draw. I'll do it, you know, just put all the names in a container or something like that, or maybe make a wheel, spin it. I don't know. But yeah, this is definitely going to be the Christmas giveaway. So I will definitely do a muffler mod to it, and I will definitely do the carburetor mod to it. But aside from that, I don't know just yet. And you'll see whatever it's going to be. Now that's that with the echoes. So let's get those out of the way. And let's talk about what else I purchased today. And I only did it because I was there on that side of the town and because a friend of mine kind of said something about wanting one of these here chassis. So this is a 266 XP, all right? It does fire up and run. But I want you to hear something. Hopefully you can hear it. Let me see. Maybe that'll work. Listen. Hear that? I have not taken it apart and checked on it yet. Let's go ahead and fire it up real quick. Sounds to me like it's got bad bearings. Whoa. Whoa. So it's pretty rough, it's pretty beat up. It is a 266 XP. And the reason I grabbed this is because I have a 266 SE, and it's just, you know, it's a basket case. But it doesn't run or anything. I was gonna rebuild that. But I found this and I was like, well, I can rebuild this, and the SE I'll give to my buddy who's going to do me a favor with my 281. We'll see how that works out. So I don't want to say anything because I don't want to put the pressure on him or any of that stuff. But yeah, it's looking like I'm going to have somebody port my 281 XP. Just because, I mean, I think it's cool to have saws that are built by other people, you know. Could I take my time and eventually get to it and build it? Yes, I could. Could I do it as good as this individual? Maybe, maybe not. I don't know. I don't care about that. What I care about, I want a saw that's been ported by him. I have a saw that's been ported by Charlie Briscoe. It's great. I love it. The Thunder Kitten. I have a saw that has been ported by Dino Joe. It's great. I love it. It's my Benford Bad Boy. I want a saw that's built by other people. You know, my idea is that whenever I go to Saw Fest next year, everything I run is going to be ported by someone else. You know, I like that idea. I'm working with John Bob Millwright, and seeing maybe he's going to do one of mine. Maybe, you know, I don't know. Maybe I'm going to just simply run one of his. I don't know. I haven't reached out to him yet, so no hope, nothing or anything, but I'd like to get something built by Aaron Lynch. I'd like to get something built by Bellhopper. But don't get me wrong. I know that all of these gentlemen are busy. And me saying this on video means nothing, okay? I am not expecting anything from anybody. Brennan Cass, he is working on my little Craftsman 3.3, which I'm excited to get. And, you know, it's just cool. Anybody who has anything to say about another builder and all that hokey pokey BS, I don't give two shits about that. I don't care. You know, a lot of people build saws, a lot of people build motorcycles, a lot of people build cars, a lot of people do a lot of things. And it really doesn't matter to me at all. I just want to have fun. And there's a lot of people that can build really well. I don't, you know, everybody's got their own style and that's fine. But yeah, so I think that's what's going to happen is this one right here will fill my personal desire for a 266. I was going to use that 266 SE, like I was saying, but since I picked this thing up, and it's already running, I think I'll just keep this one and mess with it. And then the 266 SE, let me know if you see this video, buddy. You want that? It's yours. it's pretty rough. It is, but it's also usable. So, I mean, I got it for a reason. But it's all there, and you were had mentioned that you kind of wanted one of those platforms to build something specific out of, and so let me know if you want it. And let's see, what else can I say? That's about it. That's about it. Yeah, I gotta know what that noise is. I'm hoping that it's just something. You know what? I'm hoping that it's something just in the clutch, but it sounds to me like maybe it's the PTO bearing. God dang it. Boy, somebody put that on there. Son of a bean. So, let's see real quick what we got going on here. Boy, it'd be great if it was just a simple clutch issue on this. I do believe that's a Poland bar. No, yeah, it is. Poland or Echo One, probably Poland. Yeah, that's an Echo bar. Or Poland, they're both the same thing. Whatever, you guys get it. All right, now that we got it stripped down, oh, that is rough. I ain't never seen anything like that. Look at this. How am I able to turn the crank like that? Crank broken, maybe? Let's fire it up. I don't know what's going on, but that crank's got to be broken. That's something. Because me being able to move it back and forth like that, that's like no way. No way I should be able to do that. But, whatever. Y'all ever seen something? What the F? Nah, it's moving on both sides. It totally is moving on both sides. I've never been able to spin one that freely. I mean, it's got good compression. The bearing doesn't wobble. I can hear that I am moving the rotating assembly that easy. Never been able to do that before in my life. Well, that's a mystery for another video. I'll figure that out. If you have any idea on that, what's going on with that, let me know. It's making a noise that's similar to like a bad bearing. It sounds like a bad bearing. But I can also just move it with ease. So confused right now. Anyways, let me know what you think that is, and tell me what you think I should do to the Timberwolf here for the Christmas giveaway. So keep in mind, I have time, you know, I mean, like my time is very valuable to me. So I don't know if porting it is going to be in the cards, but it might be.